Yo guys, welcome back. Okay, so aku just nak update event yang kita orang buat last week, which is yang sulam tu kan, yang dengan Universiti Malaya. Okay, so event tu berjalan dengan sangat lancar. Tapi sebelum kita pergi dengan lebih dalam, cue the intro. Okay, so guys, event tu sangat best, 2 hari. Yeah, thank you for those yang join. Appreciate so much. Okay, without you all, takkan ada event ni. So, yeah, aku nak tunjuk sikit behind the scene of the event. So today is the first day buat event UM. Jom kita tengok.
Tapi still dekat Kedah kita akan dekat sekolah, dekat Kedah pun kita akan still guna bahasa baku. So same goes to Chinese. Kalau ikutkan bahasa bahasa communicate, kita akan ikut bahasa mana yang kita selesa. So Mandarin ni basically kiranya the official untuk jadi bahasa yang baku lah.
Dia macam kalau kat Malaysia, kita kan banyak, kita banyak negeri. So kita ada logat Kedah, kita ada logat Negeri Sembilan, Pahang apa semua kan. But then yang maksudnya yang
folk, yang connect us all
bahasa baku. Macam logat macam orang Melayu KL lah, faham tak? Dia macam tak, maksud dia macam
tu lah. Bahasa baku. KL pun dia juga. So dia ada logat dekat KL. So yang connect us all is baku.
Today is our second day
basic Mandarin workshop. And I just finished my part on basic introduction.
Jom nak tengok.
Adik you buat. You tak join. You lose a lot.
So kalau kita pun, kalau kita cakap macam anything, macam contoh kita tanya dia nak minum ke apa, contoh some, macam ada orang datang rumah and then we ask him or her macam, oh nak minum tak? And then dia terus macam no. Tu kan macam,
okay guys, so kepada sesiapa yang terlepas, okay chill, relax. Okay, sebab apa, pihak FSKTM ada rakam the whole session ni, the whole session yang projek yang kita orang collaborate ni, diorang ada rakam. Tetapi korang bayang lah, event tu 3 jam. Okay, 3 jam for 2 days. So at least aku dah ada 6 jam punya session kat situ. So yeah, aku akan share dekat YouTube video aku, dan aku akan post by part lah, macam part 1, part 2, part 3 and so on. Aku tak sure ada berapa banyak part, sebab aku nak bagi, takkan aku nak post 3 jam kan, panjang sangat kan. So aku akan by part lah untuk senang korang nak tengok. So yeah, thank you for FSKTM sebab dia rakam dan dia share kat kita orang, dan kita orang minta permission untuk kita orang share kat YouTube video kita orang, dan dia bagi. So yeah, thank you. Okay, sesiapa yang nak tengok video yang part by part tu kan, aku recommend korang untuk tengok melalui komputer lah, laptop ataupun monitor ikut. Sebab apa? Screen dia besar sikit. Okay, so that lagi jelas. Dan yeah, don't forget to prepare your buku, pen untuk catik. Okay guys, so without further ado, tanpa melengahkan masa lagi, jom kita terus pergi ke part 1 of the event.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and a very good morning to all. My name is Nur Atira, and on behalf of my teams, I would like to welcome all of you to this program. We appreciate you taking off your busy schedules to join us today. For your information, this workshop is the part of our activities for Sulam Project under Teaching and Communication Skills subject that conduct by Madam Hanizura with the cooperation of our respective collaborator, Khalil Channel. This workshop is handled by 2 speakers. Let me introduce them first. For our speakers, Nur Alia Fariha, she is the second of 4 siblings, started to learn Mandarin at the age of 4, continued the journey of primary education in Kedhua, and finishing her high school in SMJK Kedhua. All of them are in Alustar Kedah. Next, the second speaker is Nur Alia Umairah. She is the youngest of 4 siblings, started to learn Mandarin at the age of 5. Continue the journey of primary education in SJK Si Kedhua in Alustar Kedah, then continue her high school in MRSM Bentong, Pahang. Currently studying in College Matrikulasi Kedah.
Okay, so we'll start. I will share about pinyin. Okay, so what is pinyin actually? So pinyin ni actually we could say macam mana kita nak sebut that Chinese word lah. So ejaan dia, ejaan untuk that perkataan. It's a system untuk kita sebut Chinese words ni accurately. So biasalah kita eja tu in romanization character lah maksudnya. Apa pula kaitan, like we know in Chinese punya words kita ada sebutan lain kan, kita ada the tones. So apa pula kaitan pinyin dengan tones ni? Okay, so tones ni dia diciptakan untuk kita sebut that Chinese word accurately. Sebab as we know in Chinese kan, kalau tone lain-lain dia ada maksud lain-lain tau. So kalau macam kita salah sebut tu, nanti dia akan jadi maksud lain. So in Chinese words ni dia tak banyak, maksudnya dia tak banyak macam in other language. Contoh bahasa Melayu kan, kita ada MA, ma. Kalau MAK jadi mak. Tapi in Chinese dia ada dia punya beberapa, maksudnya just a very limited bunyi lah. That's why dia ada tones untuk bezakan all the sebutan. Okay, so kita move on untuk first tone in pinyin. So first tone ni kita panggil flat tone. Sebab cara sebutan dia pun memang flat. So contoh kita bagi ma, MA. MA lepas tu first tone dia akan jadi ma, dia flat. Ma. So kita move on untuk second tone. Okay. Second tone pula kita panggil rising tone. So kalau tengok dia punya simbol in Chinese punya pinyin, simbol dia pun ke atas. So dia rising. Example untuk MA juga. MA in second tone dia akan jadi ma, ma. Naik atas, ma, macam tu. So untuk third tone in Chinese punya words, dia dipanggil falling rising tone. Sebab kalau tengok dia punya simbol dekat sini, dia macam macam tu, macam V kan. So dia falling, dia rising. So cara sebutan dia akan jadi ma. Dia macam turun naik, ma, macam tu. So untuk tone keempat kita ada falling tone. So kalau simbol dia pun dia menurun, dia mak, macam tu dia, cara sebutan dia mak sebab dia turun, macam tu. So cara sebutan yang untuk fourth tone ni kita boleh cakap in bahasa Melayu kita tambah K lah kat belakang, sebab dia MA tapi dia fourth tone, so kita tambah K belakang dia jadi mak, macam tu. So that's fourth tone. So actually kalau macam orang yang belajar, they will think yang actually ada empat tone je, first, second, third and fourth kan. So actually kita ada lagi satu is neutral tone tau. Neutral tone ni dia macam yang tak ada specifically tone yang 1 2 3 4 tu lah. So cara sebutan dia macam soft punya sebutan. Neutral tone ni untuk MA is masa kita tanya soalan. Selalu Chinese belakang contoh ni hao ma. Okay, so ni hao ma, ha, ma belakang tu dia neutral tone. Ha, dia macam tu lah. So basically just know that neutral tone ni dia soft sound lah, macam tu. Okay, so this is the summary of the tones in Chinese punya word. So okay, as stated there, improper usage of the tone can result in completely different words. So maksudnya, bila kita dah start belajar Chinese ni, kita nak cakap tu, we really really have to know pinyin, we really really have to know the tone so that kita sebut tu betul. So contoh macam dekat sini, nampak tak? Dia punya ejaan dia MA je, tapi dia boleh jadi a lot of different characters dan beza je hanyalah tone. Macam tu.
Okay guys, so before habis benda ni kan, aku nak, okay, once again, thank you for everything. Thank you for subscribe and everything. Terima kasih semua benda, okay. InsyaAllah lah aku akan buat lagi benda ni, okay. Ilmu yang kita kena share, okay. So kepada korang yang belum subscribe, korang boleh klik simbol atas ni, terus akan subscribe. Dan untuk korang yang nak belajar Mandarin, aku ada buat episode 1, episode 2, episode 3 pun semua. So episode 1, okay, korang boleh klik video atas ni. Dan kepada korang yang nak tengok recent video, ada di sini, bawah ni, okay. So guys, once again, thank you for everything. See you on the next video. Bye-bye.